Now, they were the band of brothers who went on to sell 100 million records, but the Osmonds have had a few blows to match the extraordinary highs.
And now the drummer and occasional lead singer, Jay Osmond, is telling the family story in the form of a musical, which is due to open next year. Let's see him and the rest of the band in action. Wow, there's some musical memories there, aren't there? Well, Jay Osmond joins us live from Arizona, where it's very early in the morning. Thank you so much for coming on the programme live. It's lovely to see you, and glad to see you keeping the home fires burning as well there. So give us an idea, Jay, about creating this musical for the family, because it's such a huge story to tell, isn't it?
Well, it's, you know, it took about 4 years to put this together, and a lot of heartfelt moments. I wanted to tell the story about the journey of our family. You know, I was writing a book called Finding My Voice, and I met this great producer named Bosse Andersson in Sweden, and he says, why don't you put your life on stage as a living memoir? And I thought, you know, that's perfect, because I wanted to tell the true story about and the journey about our family. So, you know, and it's really my story and how I saw our family and all the hard things we've gone through, and the most fantastic, unbelievable, mania kinds of things. And so I wanted to put that on stage with over 30 songs, 30 hit songs, and there's a lot of drama in it and a lot of stories that people aren't really aware of. And I think it's really going to be, it's, you know what it is? It's a feel-good night out for people. And we're going to need that in 2021, you know, when it starts in August. So I thought this is going to be finally the story that tells the truth about our family, the ups and downs, the happy times, the heartaches, and just things that I think people need to know about our family and how wonderful my brothers and sister really are.
Jay, one of the things that I think is clear is, you know, we saw this perfection, didn't we, from the family?
Yeah.
You were just so slick. But the musical itself tells the stories of not just the highs, but the lows as well. And there were some lows, weren't there?
There really were. But through those lows, we learned a lot of things about ourselves and each other. And it actually brought us together. And we were unique out there. And the story, the musical, tells why that happens. A lot of people want to know what all the true stories were and all the things. So I made a great attempt, and I'm very happy about how it turned out. When we did the workshop at Andrew Lloyd Webber's workshop, and we have his producers and the award-winning Bill Deamer as the choreographer, we've got the top quality people on this show. And when I saw the music producers and theater owners come to the workshop, and when they stood up and laughed and plotted and cried at the right times, and I just thought, and they danced, they got up and danced. I thought, okay, this is going to work. And this is what I think people need. They need a night out of happy times to go back in time and remember an era that was amazing for our family. And so I'm really happy how this has turned out.
And you talked about the highs and lows, and you were catapulted into fame at such an early age, weren't you? You were the youngest of the original five, and you're like, just looking through some of the things you did in your life, obviously drumming as well. You were taught karate by Chuck Norris. You were on TV at such an early age. You were famous at the same time as the Jackson 5 on TV as well, and you've had so many decades of this sort of fame. Jake, was it... Do you look back now and do you think that, you know, you lost a lot of your childhood, or do you look back with fond memories at all of that?
Well, I look back both. We sacrificed a lot in our childhood, but I also look back with very fond memories. And our family is a unique family, and you know when you'll see it when in the play where we started as little kids, and we will have children playing us as little kids all the way from the beginning where Walt Disney discovered us to when the 1970s took off, and we have an adult group come in who play our family, and you'll see you'll see how hard it was for us and how disciplined we were, like the Von Trapp family basically, but you'll also see some fun in there, and most importantly, it takes people through a journey through our life, and an unbelievable journey that we went through, and so. It was really fun the other night on our Thanksgiving. We had a Zoom meeting with all my family, and it was like the most amazing thing. We were laughing, we were crying, we were talking about all the hard times and all the good times, and the amazing things, the stories that this play will tell. And so I'm just thrilled about it.
Oh, Jay, that is a brilliant point to end our chat with you. It is lovely to speak to you this morning, and the very, very best of luck with it. And thank you for staying up so late.
And if you want to see more information, you go to www.theosmondsmusical.co.uk, and you'll get a lot more information on there.
Thank you, Jay.
Slick as ever. Jay, thank you very much.
He learned from a very early age. Osmond's The New Musical will premiere in London, as Jay said, in August next year before touring the UK and Ireland.
Now, it's been...